Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, today I'm going to talk about two incidents. One involved a staff member of the National Water Commission. I'm going to tell you what happened to him and what happened to the people that took his life right after. I'm also going to talk about a very spooky incident that went down in Cassava Peace. You're going to want to hear this one because, as I say, you can't even make these things up. You can't make these things up. Them things that come straight out of some kind of show. Now, first, I want to talk about the young man, right? His name was Theo. Now, he was a member, or he was a staff, at the National Water Commission. And, you know, he come from the Turnton Parkside. So, you know, say, whenever the Water Commission staff was a girl one, you know, them not really going in certain communities, right? So, of course, he ended up near the station, I wait for the bus. While he was there, 387 pounds upon him, right? Shoot him in the head, take the youth life. Now, immediately after, right, because as I said, the station, they're right around the corner. Police them hear the shot, police respond. Not long after, police them buck up in the 87s. One of them end up dead, Nawangoli. That's the one you see in the thumbnail with the fireman that might help carry him. Right? Next one get shot and injured, the hospital, and a third one get away. But I'm sure them soon catch him. Now, when may I ask, what's the motive for this? People have said, the only thing I can think of is that recently, Theo and the man named had a disagreement. Now, I'm just going to tell you what the people must say regarding the old thing they can think of. I don't know if down the road another motive is going to come out, but this is what happened in the build-up to Theo losing his life. Him and the man them, right, had a disagreement. Guess where the Marcos over? So because Theo work at National Commission, National Water Commission, you know, so when you have a steady job and you make a steady income, naturally, you know, certain ends, man, I go constantly link you and I beg you a thing and give me this and do this to me. And Theo basically tell the man them, say, oh, you must stop give them things, stop give them money, stop beg him, go look work, right? And from what I'm understanding, him say it in a very, you know, he basically run them way. He basically run them way, say, so go look work and stop beg him. But it's like before, them used to beg him and get the things. So, him suddenly tell him no. I've said it many times. You can give a parasite something 500 times. The one time them hear no, let me take your life. Because in a feel of mind, them give you something to put on. Especially when you talk to them in a way where they might think to themselves, oh, would I better talk to? Can't talk to bad man like that. Remember, 87's ego fragile, you know. Now, when I saw the pictures on Jamaica Gleaner, I could see a family mourning, and at first I thought it was Theo's family. Me, I think say Theo's family a ball for him and I say, boy, look what him did. Now, I get to understand, say, the picture that me see is actually the 87 family, the one where police killed back instantly. A film family a ball. Now, of course, me understand, naturally, whether you're 87 or not, your family are going to miss you. Right? But when you look on the pictures, I swear, say, him are the original victim. If you didn't know the backstory, right, you'd be thinking, boy, look how another youth just gone, just like that police just gonna kill him. But the full story is that them just done kill Theo. Police kill them back right away, or at least one of them, the next one get shot. See, from what them realize, say, enough of these 87s that get instant karma. Right, you know, when people talk about karma, they might get it instantly. Right. Remember, I'm the swarm to Walker. Right, so I'm to that brother, you know. And as me said, the whole thing go down, right, the station, they right on the corner, so I know all them things, say them could go shoot, man. Right, and then police, they rush out, same time. Because soon as the shooting go down, police start look for them. And you see them, they get away, them that brag and say, you see how big, what I'm brave, we shot, man, right next to the station, cause we're not business about nothing. Right, the way we bad, we go shot to you, right, the station, they right on the corner, we're not business, them that brag about it. Them not brag about it, but guess what? Them luck run out. So the people them really upset, right? Because me say Theo work for National Water Commission. So you know, it was like them, you know, anytime people want to do it, NWC, if they have any kind of issues with pipe or whatever, any kind of water issues, because you know the community, and they can get to him directly, right? It was it was seen as an asset to the community because they don't know. Instead of going up to Water Commission and try speaking to customer service or whatever, you could have a link to you, right, and him get certain things done for you faster. So enough people have reached out to me, enough people upset. But as I get more information, I'll pass it on. Now let's talk about cassava peas. Now get find a stance. Police are patrol cassava peas. About 11 o'clock in the night, Saturday night. Them see a group of man, and as them spot the man them, one of the man them dash something at the gully. Right, you don't know up on the gully side. Him threw a gun in the gully. So, police rush on upon him same time. Guess what the people them do? Guess what the rest of the residents and the man them around the brother throw the gun in the gully do? Start stoning the police. Start stoning the police to the point where the police them now are too busy to try take cover. So them can't even get a hold on upon the man and the man escape. Think about that for a second. Now show when you see them sitting in. Jamaica have to be some. What me tell you, Jamaica is a Netflix series. Police are go for lock up man with them see illegal gun, dash gun in a gully. And the people them around the man stone the police. And make police can't lock up the man. Stone him. And here's the thing. Me have to commend the police them. Let me tell you why. I get enough time people do some things where they put the police in a lose-lose situation. Let me explain. When you see people fling stone off a police in a situation like this, they know what they're doing. They know what they're doing. You see, them strategies, even if the police was to shoot back now and shoot somebody, you're the narrative. All them there do a fling to stone. Why the police have to shoot? Well, stone can't do nobody. See, it's a police now. It's a lose-lose situation. So, police them never shoot nobody, right? They never shoot no resident. And, you know, the agents down the narrative run with this time. They did, however, kick some of the people that would have fling stone after them, right? And they also recovered the legal gun with the youth chewing at the gully. But they never catch the youth with chewing. But the police sent to them know him, right? As somebody within the system. So it probably not gonna last long. But when they hear me say, in a bad man place, certain residents act as agents of the 87s. And I find that's what I'm talking about. Obviously, Simple Simon will not talk about everybody, right? Because some people in a cassava piece, in a business born of badness, in a business born of violence, and get up and go on their work. Right in another time from the 87. Yes, we know that Simple Simon. But they're agents. They're agents who know them job and know them rule and know if this happen, them for do this. People practice and rehearse what should happen in case police come. When we tell them, say, for example, right, garden, kerosene, them are experts at throwing themselves on the 87 10 job. Right. Throw themselves on ball and roll the dirt and draw a crowd on the 87. And you think some morning I go on, I tell them I take up the gun. Take up the gun and gone. They probably don't even know the 87 pan the gun. But them rehearse and them practice them, know them drills, them know them rules. But you see, when stories like this come out, all it is open the public eyes. Because there was a time when there was no spotlight shed on some of the residents and the fact that some of them are agents. One time, people never used to look on it from that angle. People still have a look, say, oh well, you know, all of the residents over here, so, and them now boss no gun, so why them I get mixed up in this? No. You have 87 more boss gun, but you have residents that are agents. Right. They aid and abet the 87s to carry out them acts. Right. So they might not shoot off at the police themselves, but they're also a part of the operation. Same way, just like we have people in the military who they don't go on frontline duty. Right. But they play a very important role in any operation, right? And the same thing happened in the criminal world, right? You have people who Then they're on the front line and shoot up a police. They're not shooting nobody, robbing nobody. Right? But you have residents who are agents who for them job is very important for the success of the 87. Either getting away or carrying out some kind of criminal activity. And for years, there was no spotlight shed upon them. But that's changing. That's changing. And one of the saddest things about it is that the people in the community who don't mix up with the foolishness, people who just want to go about them business and just go about them job, right? And, you know, law-abiding people who, for example, come from Cassava Peace, right? When things like this go down, then they know it's a be a police now go swarm like the place, right? Enough people who, them don't mix up none, but just because them live on the same lane where this go down, right now be a searching and, you know, every minute them see Jeep a pass through and them life get inconvenient. But as them say, sometime in our life, the good have to suffer for the bad, right? Because at the same time, you can't have something like this go down and not show a strong presence. You have to make it known that this should not be tolerated within reason, right? Of course, we're not supporting the police just go around and randomly beat up people and all them foolishness there, right? But the people who actually carry out this act, stone police, let me say some of them get catched. The 87 would have shot the gun. We have to get bring in too. So, we can see how this one play out. Anyway, that's it for today, people. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. BIA, you don't know. More life. Ultra squad, stay circling.